What do you get when you combine advanced AI algorithms, an enormous dataset, and a sprinkle of human-like language skills? You get ChatGPT, the chatty language model that can respond to our questions and carry on conversations. But beware, my friends, because it may sometimes generate hallucinations or fictional information. When hallucinating, ChatGPT may provide details about historical events that didn't actually occur or inaccurately describe significant moments in history. It could claim that Henry VIII invented the internet. Or that Cleopatra was a secret spy for aliens. ChatGPT can even try to become Nostradamus 2.0 and attempt to predict the future. It could suggest that we'll have flying cars powered by unicorn magic. Or that humans will colonize Mars using teleportation. Fascinating, but not quite grounded in reality. Don't believe everything you hear, friends. These hallucinations arise due to factors such as limitations in training data, inherent biases, or the model's tendencies to generate imaginative or creative responses. There are some prompt engineering techniques that can reduce the likelihood of hallucinations and promote more accurate outputs from AI language models. Let's explore some of these techniques. In this technique, you provide a problem statement to ChatGPT and ask the model to solve the problem by thinking step by step. Let's see some practical applications of this technique. What is the square root of 169? Use this format. Question. Repeat the question I asked. Answer. Let's think step by step. Give reasoning. Then provide the final answer. Let's run this example. Here's what ChatGPT responded.
Let's think step by step. The square root of a number is a value that, when multiplied by itself, gives the original number. In this case, we are looking for the value that, when multiplied by itself, gives us 169. To find the square root of 169, we can use the principle that the square root of a number is equal to the number raised to the power of 1/2. Now, let's evaluate 169 raised to the power of 1/2. Therefore, the square root of 169 is 13.
We can see how ChatGPT solved this problem and communicated the steps taken to resolve it. Here's another example of solving a mathematical expression. Solve the equation 3x plus 7 is equal to 22. Let's run this example. We can see how ChatGPT solved this problem and communicated the steps taken to resolve it. This technique can help learners understand the logic behind mathematical concepts and builds their problem-solving skills. You can also use this technique for important decision-making. This is an example. Should we invest in expanding our product line or focus on marketing our existing products? Think step by step. Give reasoning. And then provide the final answer. Let's run this example. When faced with important decisions, using this technique helps individuals consider all relevant factors step by step. It involves evaluating the pros and cons, analyzing the potential consequences of each option, and providing reasoning for the final decision. This approach promotes a logical and thoughtful decision-making process. Let's ask ChatGPT to solve this problem. How can we reduce traffic congestion in a busy city center? Let's think step by step. Give reasoning. And then provide the final answer. When faced with a complex problem, using this technique helps break it down into smaller, more manageable steps. By providing reasoning at each stage, it ensures a systematic approach to problem solving and increases the chances of finding an accurate solution. In this technique, you request ChatGPT to supply a reference or citation as a means of verifying the accuracy of the information it provides. Let's try this out. What important events happened in the year when man landed on the moon? Answer only using reliable sources and cite those sources. You can see how ChatGPT presented the links from which it gathered the information. We can also combine citation and step-by-step approaches together. In this format, you can see how we are asking AI to take a step-by-step approach in its response, cite sources, and give reasoning before sharing final answer. Let's see an example. What country hosted the FIFA World Cup the year France won the UEFA European Championship? Take a step-by-step approach in your response, cite sources, and give reasoning before sharing final answer in the given format. Observe how ChatGPT presented us with logical reasoning, accompanied by a citation, within its response. You can also add a statement. Make sure your answer is exactly correct. After your ChatGPT prompt to force it to provide the correct response. Let's try an example. Act as a chemist and tell me the specific year when the periodic table was first published. Make sure your answer is exactly correct.
The periodic table was first published in the year 1869.
Here's another example. Act as a biologist and tell me the year when the structure of DNA was discovered. Make sure your answer is exactly correct.
The structure of DNA, known as the double helix, was discovered in the year 1953.
In these examples, by asking AI to ensure that the answer is exactly correct, you are emphasizing the importance of accuracy and encouraging the model to provide a more thoughtful and accurate response. Now, let's introduce our next technique to obtain factual results from the AI model. Give the model an out. It can sometimes be helpful to give the model an alternative path if it is unable to complete the assigned task. For example, when asking a question over a piece of text, you might include something like, "Respond with not found," or "I don't know if the accurate answer is not found." This can help the model avoid generating false responses and reduces the likelihood of hallucinations, and instead encourages ChatGPT to provide more reliable and informative answers. Let's try this out. We first asked ChatGPT a direct question. How GPT-4 is better than GPT-3.5 model? Despite lacking the necessary information, the AI model began to engage in speculation and make assumptions. You can observe how it presented assumptions on how GPT-4 could potentially surpass GPT-3. Let's attempt the prompt once more, providing the model with an option to acknowledge the truth if it cannot locate the requested information. This time, the model admitted its lack of the necessary information. Rather than speculating, it advised us to consult official sources or recent research papers to obtain accurate and up-to-date information. In cases where the AI-generated content involves factual information or claims, crafting prompts that emphasize the importance of accuracy and truthfulness can help mitigate the risk of misinformation. For example, see this prompt. Provide a well-researched and fact-checked summary of the key events and developments related to climate change in the past decade. It is important to remember that a well-designed prompt can increase the likelihood of a certain outcome, but it is still possible that an incorrect response could be generated. Therefore, it is crucial for users to critically evaluate AI-generated responses, fact-check information, and consult reliable sources to ensure accuracy. And that concludes our journey through the hallucinations of ChatGPT. We've explored how AI-generated responses can sometimes blur the line between fact and fiction and how we can avoid it. We can't solely rely on ChatGPT to be our ultimate truth-teller. We must be responsible consumers of AI-generated content. Remember, curiosity is key, but critical thinking is paramount in navigating this AI-powered world. As always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell, so you never miss any of our exciting AI adventures. Take care, and see you soon!